A lot of people talk about machine learning as if it is some other new thing, like or new tool to use in your startup, like JavaScript or, hey, this is mobile responsive design or whatever. It's not. It's the way the whole software world functions. A good way to get your head around how big an impact machine learning is going to have on our lives, not just on music and entertainment, is to realize that about 80% of the software written today is software written for other software to run. It's not written as software for human beings to interface and work with. It's software for other software. And if you start to get your head around that, the processing power and the decision-making and the automation that's possible inside of even the smallest apps on your mobile phone, there really isn't a part of entertainment or culture or, again, human life that isn't going to be touched by the way machine learning functions. We've made a bunch of different investments in companies that use machine learning to create new things that were previously impossible. Right? Like we have a portfolio company called Popgun that uses machine learning to make an AI music engine to make parts of songs and song packs so that kids can rearrange them and DJ and perform. The product of that company is kids entertaining themselves and performing. The requirement to do that is to be able to have sort of an unlimited supply of music. The product of the company is not this unlimited supply of AI-driven music. The product of the company is an experience of performing. But a prerequisite to perform is to have access to songs and have access to parts and have an unlimited supply of them so that everybody can have their unique performances and their unique compositions. Think of it in that way, whereas it solves sort of some of the hardest supply problems, or it solves some of the hardest decision-making problems. What it allows is new businesses to be created on the other side. Another of our portfolio companies, Replica, makes AI voices, like voice clones. So you can record your voice and then the AI can reinterpret text you type, and it speaks as if you are speaking and gives someone the control to direct your emotion and your inflection and the tone of what it is that you're saying. Now we don't have to have voiceover actors. Now we don't have to have a bunch of things that take a long time to create really truly immersive experiences. Now you can play a video game and talk to the other characters, right? Instead of having to interface with someone through the controller, you can just talk to them in a much more natural way. It creates a much more human, much more deeply immersive experience. The product, again, is not Replica voices. The product is APIs and tools for directing that so that you can build other amazing experiences on top of that. But the way that machine learning functions and the way that computers can learn and iterate and not make decisions, but create things and predict the way behavior is going to go and target content for you at the right moment allows deep personalization, deep immersion, you know, really individual one-on-one experiences that were otherwise just impossible without it. And so I think if you're thinking about machine learning as a way that it impacts your career as an artist or how you want to get involved in the music business, you don't necessarily have to become a developer there. It's currently a very mathematics intensive, right, deep part of science, but you should definitely do a lot of reading and be savvy enough to be dangerous in those conversations, because you'll start to understand the impacts of the way things will work. The Spotify algorithm, right, your For You playlist, the way TikTok presents videos to you when you're trying to kill 10 minutes and watch, and the way they constantly always get it right and the content is so engaging and interesting. All of that is driven by algorithms digging deep into giant databases, terabytes of data about user preferences and behavior, and predicting and selecting things for you to consume. And so you will both benefit from that and have to fight against it and have to figure out how to optimize your work to go live in that world. And if you don't understand how they work, it just puts you at a disadvantage.